हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट रिगार्डिंग टाइप्स ऑफ डिस्पर्शन। ओके, टाइप्स ऑफ डिस्पर्शन। सो ऑलरेडी वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट रिगार्डिंग डिस्पर्शन, राइट? सो इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट डिस्पर्शन। ओके, सो डिस्पर्शन इज नथिंग बट हियर पल्स स्प्रेडिंग। ओके, पल्स स्प्रेडिंग, सो बाय विच द सिग्नल विल बी डिस्टॉर्टेड। ओके, पल्स डिस्पर्शन बाय विच द सिग्नल विल बी डिस्टॉर्टेड, राइट? सो डिस्पर्शन इज नथिंग बट हियर पल्स स्प्रेडिंग। ओके, सो देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ डिस्पर्शंस ओवर देर, राइट? रिगार्डिंग दिस डिस्पर्शन, ओके, देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ डिस्पर्शंस आर देर। ओके, दोज टू आर, फर्स्ट वन इज इंट्रा मॉडल डिस्पर्शन एंड इंटर मॉडल डिस्पर्शन। ओके, इंट्रा मॉडल डिस्पर्शन एंड इंटर मॉडल dispersion. Intramodal dispersion is also called as chromatic dispersion. Okay, intramodal dispersion is also called as chromatic dispersion. Fine. Now coming to the in these two dispersions, now first we discuss regarding intramodal dispersion. Okay, so in those two types of dispersions, we discuss regarding intramodal dispersion. So here the intramodal dispersion is also called as chromatic dispersion. Fine. Now this intramodal dispersion, okay, this intramodal dispersion occurs in single mode fibers. Okay, already we discussed regarding modes of fibers, right? Single mode and multi mode fibers, right? So this type of intramodal dispersion, okay, it occurs in single mode fibers. Okay, so whenever we apply the light through the optical fiber from a light source, okay, whenever we apply light through the optical fiber by the optical source, right, so this type of spreading, okay, this spreading, whatever it is, chromatic dispersion, right, this spreading occurs from the finite spectral emission width. Okay, it arises from the finite spectral emission width of an optical source, right? So here we are applying the light from the optical source to the optical fiber, right? So this dispersion, okay, the spreading arises from finite spectral emission width of an optical source. Okay, actually dispersion is a result of group velocity. Okay, it is a result of group velocity being a function of wavelength. Okay, this dispersion is a result of group velocity being a function of wavelength. So it results of group velocity, no? That's why this chromatic dispersion or intramodal dispersion is also called as group velocity dispersion. Okay, so this dispersion results from group velocity being a function of wavelength. Hence this intramodal dispersion is also called as chromatic dispersion as well as group velocity dispersion. Fine. Actually, what is the group velocity here? Okay, what is the group velocity now? It means that, so group velocity is the speed at which the energy in a particular mode travels along the fiber. Okay, the group velocity is the speed at which the energy in a particular mode travels along the fiber. Fine. Because here the intramodal dispersion depends on the wavelength here. Okay, the intramodal dispersion depends on the wavelength. Okay, so this effect on signal distortion increases with the spectral width of light source. Okay, the intramodal dispersion effect on the signal distortion increases with the spectral width of light source. So whatever the light source you are taking, okay, mostly it occurs in single mode fibers, right? For single mode fibers we are taking the laser here, right? So with that source, okay, light source, that is the laser, okay, it increases with the spectral width of laser light. Okay, next, the spectral width is the band of wavelength here. Okay, the spectral width is the band of wavelength over which the source emits the light. Okay, The spectral width is the band of wavelength over which the source emits the light. Fine. Next, again this intermodal dispersion is divided into two types. Okay, the main two causes of intermodal dispersion are of two types over there. First one is material dispersion. Second one is waveguide dispersion. Okay, first one is material dispersion. Second one is waveguide dispersion. Now coming to the first one, material dispersion. Okay, material dispersion. It arises due to the variations of refractive index of core. Okay, this type of dispersion arises from the variations of refractive index of the core material as a function of wavelength. Okay, that is the material dispersion here. Hence, the material dispersion is also called as chromatic dispersion. Okay, it is also referred to as chromatic dispersion because it is same as the effect by which the prism, okay, if you take the prism, it will be spread out the spectrum, right? When you take the prism, okay, when you emit the light on a prism, it will spread out the spectrum over there, right? So hence this material dispersion is also called as chromatic dispersion. Fine. So in this material dispersion, okay, the pulse spreading occurs when different wavelengths follow the same path. Okay, pulse spreading occurs when different wavelengths follow the same path. Okay, so here the different wavelengths are over there, right? Whenever we are emitting the light in the optical fiber, right? So this spreading occurs whenever the different wavelengths follow the same path, right? Next, to calculate this material dispersion, okay, to calculate this material dispersion, consider a plane wave, okay, having the refractive index. Okay, you consider a plane which is having refractive index and it varies non-linearly with the wavelength. Okay, it varies non-linearly with the wavelength. For this plane we are applying a light, okay, and this plane is having dielectric medium. Okay, so whenever we apply the light, okay, that plane is having the plane is having refractive index, right? At that time the second differential of the refractive index, okay, the second differentiation of the refractive index with respect to wavelength is not equal to zero here, right? The second differential of the refractive index with respect to the wavelength is not equal to zero, right? That is d square n by d lambda square is not equal to zero. Okay, d square n by d lambda square is not equal to zero. That means the second differential of the refractive index with respect to the wavelength is not equal to zero here. Next, the pulse spread, okay, the pulse spread due to the material dispersion can be obtained by considering the group delay. Okay, the pulse spread due to the material dispersion may be obtained by considering the group delay, that is TG, okay, T suffix G. It is the reciprocal of group velocity. Okay, the TG, group delay, is the reciprocal of group velocity, that is VG here, right? So V suffix G. Now coming to this group velocity, that is the group velocity here, I have written here, the group velocity VG is equal to dW by d beta. Fine, dW by d beta, where beta is mode propagation factor, that is constant here. Next, W is the spectral width. Whatever the light source we are applying to the optical fiber, right, that is having some spectral width here. Okay, that is the W. Next, the group delay, okay, hence the group delay TG is the reciprocal of group velocity, that is 1 by VG here. Fine, 1 by VG, that is 1 by dW by d beta. So we can write it as d beta by dW. So that can be expressed in refractive index as 1 by C into N1 minus lambda into dN1 by d lambda. Okay, so that is of group delay, that is TG. Fine, where N1 is the refractive index and lambda is the wavelength here and C is the speed of the light over there. Fine. एंड नेक्स्ट वन द पल्स डिले. ओके द पल्स डिले TM. ओके ड्यू टू द मटेरियल डिस्पर्शन इन ए फाइबर. ओके द फाइबर इज हैविंग लेंथ L, राइट. देन द पल्स डिले TM इज एक्सप्रेस्ड एज L बाई C इंटू N1 माइनस लैम्डा इंटू DN1 बाई D लैम्डा. ओके इज द फर्स्ट इक्वेशन. TM इज इक्वल टू L बाई C इंटू N1 माइनस लैम्डा इंटू DN1 बाई D लैम्डा. फाइन. Now the RMS value of the pulse spread. Okay, here the pulse spread can be mentioned with the sigma m. Fine. The RMS value of sigma m can be obtained by expanding the equation in a Taylor series. Okay, here the Taylor series has to be expressed here for the pulse spread. Okay, the pulse spread sigma is m is equal to sigma lambda dTm by d lambda plus sigma lambda into 2d square. Tm by T D lambda square plus and so on. Okay, so there is a Taylor series of this pulse spreading. Okay, that is of the sigma m. Now neglecting by neglecting these higher order terms, we will get it as sigma m is approximately equal to sigma lambda into D Tm by D lambda. Okay, here we are neglecting the higher order terms. Fine, in this equation we are neglecting the higher order terms. Then we will get this equation for sigma m, that is pulse spread. Okay, now here we see the terms. Okay, whatever we have written, dTm by d lambda. Okay, in this equation dTm by d lambda is there, right? So here we have to differentiate the Tm with respect to the lambda. Okay, by differentiating the Tm, the first equation, right, with respect to lambda, we will get it as L lambda by C. Okay, L lambda by C into dN1 by d lambda minus d square n1 by d lambda square minus dn1 by d lambda. With respect to lambda, we have to differentiate the equation of Tm here. Then we will get it as dTm by d lambda equal to minus L lambda by C into d square n1 by d lambda square here. Fine. And next one, so by substituting this dTm by d lambda in this equation sigma m, right, we will get it as sigma m is equal to sigma lambda into minus L lambda by C into d square n1 by d lambda square. So by this equation, if you take the modulus, okay, if you take the mod, okay, we will get it as sigma lambda into L divided by C mod L, sorry, lambda d square n1 by d lambda square. This one is the pulse spread in terms of refractive index as well as wavelength here. Fine. So that is of sigma m lambda here, sorry, sigma m. So if you write this mod, okay, whatever the terms are there in mod, right, so that is equal to d mat here, that is the material dispersion. Okay, d mat of lambda. Okay, so where d mat of lambda is the material dispersion, right? Already we discussed regarding this material dispersion. Okay, so d mat of lambda is called as the material dispersion here. So this material dispersion, okay, this material dispersion can be reduced at longer wavelengths. Okay, when you are having the longer wavelengths, this material dispersion can be reduced over there. Fine. So that is regarding material dispersion. Okay, so today we discussed regarding these material dispersions, right? There are two main causes of intramodal dispersions over there: material dispersion and waveguide dispersion. So in next video we see regarding waveguide dispersion here. So up to now we discussed regarding material dispersion. In next video we discuss about regarding waveguide dispersion. Okay, so there is regarding types of dispersions over there, right? In types of dispersion we are having two dispersions over there, right? One is the intramodal dispersion, second one is of intermodal dispersion, right? Intramodal dispersion again causes with the material dispersion and waveguide dispersion. Fine. In next video, we discuss regarding waveguide dispersion over there. Okay, thank you all. Thank you.